If you're wondering how to understand the effectiveness of your workout, look no further than your heart. Today's video is about the latest update for Oura Ring and Gucci Oura Ring. It is the long-awaited workout heart rate. We'll go through how to use it, what activities are supported at the moment, and the first impressions of how it's performing. But also we'll talk about what exactly happens to your heart rate during exercise, and what does it tell us. And if you're new to Oura Ring, check out my other Oura Ring videos as well. There's plenty of info, including latest Gucci Oura Ring as well. But now, let's have a look how to use workout heart rate in your Oura Ring. If you are having Oura Ring in airplane mode, first thing you'll notice that it needs connection to your phone. So in this case, you'll need to put it on a charger to deactivate airplane mode. And when you're ready to go, under the plus tab, select record workout heart rate and then select your activity and press record. In this example, we'll have running. Now, during your activity, it will record your heart rate. It will also track your location, so it draws your route on a map, which is nice. At the moment, Oura Ring supports running, cycling and walking, and Oura is saying that more workouts to be added throughout the year. Once you're done, you'll press pause and then stop recording, and you'll see Oura app synchronizing collected data, and after a few seconds, it'll show you statistics of your exercise, including your route on the map and the distance, duration of your exercise, heart rate, time, your speed, and active calorie burn. And you can view your workout heart rate in the daytime heart rate card on home screen, as it adds it there as well. Now, one thing to notice is, when you're done, you need to remember to stop recording, as even if you have clearly stopped your exercise, it doesn't automatically stop recording. In case you forgot to stop recording, you can adjust it by editing the time it took. Another thing is that to get your heart rate recorded, your Oura Ring must have a snug fit, meaning if your ring is a bit loose, you might not get your heart rate recorded. And this has happened to me. Mostly I do get heart rate readings, but not always. I have my ring comfortable, a little loose in finger but not really tight, and Oura is recommending to have a tighter fit for this third generation ring compared to earlier version. And this might be a usability issue for some, as with any ring, you'll notice that your fingers can be a little bit larger or smaller during the days, and also between seasons. Like in the winter time, it's usually a bit smaller, and in summertime, a little more swollen. So you basically can't have always a optimal snug fit. But let's talk about the workout heart rate in general. By measuring your heart rate during exercise, it can help you track your fitness and monitor if you're working out at the right level for you. This means you won't be guessing anymore when it comes to exercise. With your heart rate, you'll know how effective your fitness session has been and how much rest and recovery you need before your next one. While your heart rate accurately indicates your effort and exercise intensity, it's also dependent on circumstances. There are several factors that influence heart rate during exercise, like training background, temperature, dehydration, but one of the key factors that influence our heart rate is age. Like so many parts of our body, your heart's capacity and functionality changes over the course of your life. So your age is a useful metric for estimating your maximum heart rate. Now, there are tests for measuring your maximum heart rate that makes you sweat a lot, obviously. We're talking about running tests and similar, but your maximum heart rate can be estimated with the commonly used formula, which is 220 minus your age. So, for example, 20-year-old maximum heart rate would be 200, and for 70-year-old that would be 150. And when you know your maximum heart rate, you can plan your exercises by using different heart rate zones. There are 5 zones. Lightest is where your heart rate is 50 to 60% of your maximum heart rate, and it goes up in steps, where the first one is considered very light. And next is light, at 60 to 70%, going up to moderate and hard and maximum zone. An effective running plan or workout plan will include different types of workouts with varying frequency, duration and intensity, spaced out so that you have time to recover. This means that some workouts should be short and intense, some long and light, some can be even long and tough. It's a variety that makes your workout regimen effective. I've been now using workout heart rate tracking if I go out on a bicycle, walking, or I go jogging. It is a solid improvement to your Oura Ring, and especially if you're not having any other fitness tracker like Apple Watch, for example. Oura Ring now gives you a lot more data than just collecting your steps. Naturally, the sleep tracking is its core function, but now these other functions add its value a lot more. But it does have some issues if your ring is not having a snug fit. But next update, what will be waiting is blood oxygen sensing. It's set to come in summer 22. So we don't have any exact month when it's arriving, but let's wait. It shouldn't be that far now. This is an interesting feature, understanding variations in your overnight blood oxygen level. A measure of how well your body circulates and absorbs oxygen will help you get an even more enhanced read on the quality of your nightly rest. And as it measures it during the night, we shouldn't have any issues with the ring being too loose to get the readings, but let's see when it arrives. And if you're new to this channel, I'm an engineer that has passion for everyday technology, health technology, smart home, but also personal finance and lifestyle topics. You'll find me also from social medias. And if you made it this far, I hope today's video was useful. Please drop a like and let me know in the comments if you have any questions, experiences, or whatever comes to your mind. I'll try to answer all. Thank you so much for watching, have a great day, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.